The following opinions are solely those of BoatTest.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTest.com, and today we're going to conduct a sea trial and features inspection of the newest launch from Boston Whaler, the 380 Outrage. It replaces the multi-award-winning 370 Outrage at the height of its popularity in the market, no less, and revitalized it with a boat that has many improvements to the on-deck and below-deck appointments, created a new running surface, and completely renewed the boat to better complement the rest of the Outrage line. The Boston Whaler 380 Outrage has a length overall of 38 feet, a beam of 11 feet 8 inches, and a draft of 23.5 inches. With an empty weight of 14,500 pounds, 44% fuel, 2 people in test power, and nearly 1 ton of optional features added on, we had an estimated test weight of 20,094 pounds. We tested with Mercury's new Cruise Assist system controlling the engine speeds, and all the engines were set on auto trim, and both systems performed flawlessly. So, for our first time testing with everything on full auto, and the Triple Merc 350 Verados turning 16x17 Inertia Eco props, we reached our top speed of 50 miles per hour at 6,200 RPM. Best cruise was measured at 4,000 RPM and 29.3 miles per hour. At that speed, the 32.7 gallon per hour fuel burn translated into 0.9 miles per gallon and a range of 359 miles, all while still holding back a 10% reserve of the boat's 445 gallon total fuel capacity. And remember, this performance is with the added weight of the many options, the Tower and Seakeeper Gyro among the heaviest. New for this model, the 380 is now offered with a quad engine setup in either 350 or 400 horsepower configurations. For this update, we tested her with quad 400 Verados turning 18 pitch props. Top speed was 57.8 miles per hour. Best cruise came in at 4,000 RPM and 32.9 miles per hour. At that speed, the 42.4 gallon per hour fuel burn translated into 0.8 miles per gallon and a range of 312 statute miles. Of course, all while still holding back a 10% reserve of the boat's 445 gallon total fuel capacity. We reached planing speed in an average 3.8 seconds, accelerated to 20 miles per hour in 5.4 seconds, and continued through 30 in 7.5. We tested in protected water and got a good feel for the way the 380 Outrage handles. She's got that newly designed hull drafted from a clean sheet of paper, and we found her to be responsive and well-mannered in the calm waters of our test area. However, this is a Boston Whaler, so what matters is how she handles offshore. We took her out in winds blowing 30 to 35 with 8 to 10 foot rollers and had at it. Turns out, this 380 Outrage handles with the grace of the 420. Solid, predictable, and well-mannered. It was unbelievable. There was never a moment where we felt compromised, and indeed we had no desire to turn around and head back to the protected inlet. She has a narrow entry giving clean penetration, and that new 23 degree dead rise makes for a soft re-entry with water being thrown wide and low. She'll still take spray, wind being what it is, but it's minimized from this new design, and the ability of the dynamic tab system to lower the nose in this heavy surf is just without equal, and it's all automatic. This boat also has a Seakeeper Gyro Stabilizer. During our test of that, the unit worked great, and this is a feature that will not only be appreciated by the families, but the fishermen that will be standing for long periods. Now, let's look over some of her features, starting with ops.
There are some new features in the Boston Whaler 380 Outrage. The cushions of the 380 have been changed from gray to tan, and the dashboard color is also now tan. Now let's take a look at the rest of her features.
The ship's 110 electrical panel is at the cabin entry. The 12-volt panel is to the starboard bulkhead adjacent to the helm seats, and this also includes the ignitions. The console profile shares the aggressive new styling the current Outrage models possess, and it looks great. It's a very angular and modern design, with the console itself being offset to the starboard side with the actual helm station mounted right on the center line. It's surrounded by tempered glass on three sides, and an electrically actuated vent is at the top of the forward windshield. Defrost vents are just behind. Facing the operator are the Seakeeper panel, the active trim panel, and the latest iteration of the vessel view in an opening glove box with tension hinges. The operator, helm, and compass are right on the center line. A soft touch vinyl dash cover and brow top off the console, and Boston Whaler thoughtfully added a welcome space for putting stuff that includes an accessory plug-in USB port. Rocker switches line the top of the panel. Heat and AC vents are in the center. To me, the most significant switches are the boost switch for the heat and AC, and the forward vent switch. The panel has been cleaned up significantly, and the glass dash concept features two 165GS screens mounted into an acrylic backing. Below are three engine start stops, the Fusion stereo, the remote for the spotlight, the stainless wheel has a convenient steering knob, and it's all mounted to a tilt base. The automatic trim tabs are alongside, and this haul really made me a fan of those. The digital throttle and shift binnacle is next, and then Mercury's JPO or joystick piloting for outboards with heading hold autopilot, waypoint steering, skyhook, drift hook, and bow hook included. Dual footrests are below. Directly overhead is storage for the full weather enclosure, and this highlights a theme of Boston Whaler storing items near where they will be used. And it's not lost on me that we still have 6 feet 8 inches of headroom under this storage space. The seats are 3 across, with each one having individual armrests, bolsters, and the captain's is electrically adjustable fore and aft. The portside observer gets a separate flip-down footrest, since this seat is not at the console, and I love this. A flip-down elevated deck for bringing us short captains up 6 more inches, and it's covered with anti-fatigue sea decking. Behind this panel is the Seakeeper Gyro. The hardtop and tower supports are integrated into the console so as not to impede on the side deck space. We access the tower from a set of stairs and a sliding hatch to port. It features a small nav display, a vessel view display, remote spotlight control, horn, start stops, tilt-based steering, VHF is below, the engine controls, and the joystick. The double-wide seat has individual bolsters with storage underneath. Outriggers are to the side, and overhead is a protective hardtop providing much-appreciated shade. At the foredeck, a hatch concealed the vertically mounted Lumar windlass. The anchor is mounted through the stem, a cleat is provided for securing the road, a remote mounts to the void area that also houses a washdown spigot and room to access the road. The hatch cover is finished to both sides, is supported with a stainless steel support strut, and opens with a turn and lock latch. When closed, the entire foredeck is treated with diamond non-skid and includes pull-up cleats and rod holders. At the cockpit, a deck hatch lifts to reveal the mechanical room with lots of features. Basically, all the mechanical components of the 380 are combined into this one compartment. There's a flip-down deck that makes it easier to work here. Underneath are the batteries. Looking around, we've got the fire suppression system, the fishbox macerator pump, the holding tank discharge, the live well pump, 2 power steering pumps, the battery charger, fresh water pump, raw water pump, water manifolds, automatic battery switches and parallels, another power steering pump, fuel filters, the second fishbox macerator, air conditioning pump, gyro pump, raw water strainers, bilge pumps, oh, and the generator. For fishing features, the cockpit measures in at 45 square feet, providing plenty of fighting room. To the sides are huge fish boxes that are refrigerated and macerated. Forward, there are spreader lights behind the hardtop, 2 color courtesy lights, a remote camera, and rod holders in the supports. In the quarters, there are 10-inch cleats, washdown spigots, speakers, and cannonball holders integrated into tow rails. A hatch alongside opens to a drawer designed to hold a 5-gallon bucket. The whole deck is canted to channel water to the twin deck drains to each side. The button to the top activates the auto-flush system for the engines. Just hook up a single hose and press this switch to flush all engines out with fresh water. There's a 60-gallon transom live well that's divided for separating baits, and it also has the added benefit of keeping the water from sloshing back and forth. At the bow, of course, everything can be lowered to form an elevated casting platform complete with diamond non-skid that's great for a cast netter or bait caster. A dive door is to the port side bulwarks for hauling in that big catch, and when using it as a dive door, a reboarding ladder that stores close by at the transom mounts right in. A grab handle is just inside. Because it opens inward, this also makes an ideal spot to board from a floating dock. And notice how the bulwarks come out slightly to allow you to walk right past the door and not jam your leg into it. Nice touch there. Families will also appreciate a lot of what the 380 has to offer, and to us, the newly designed outrage bow is the main attraction. The bulwarks are drawn outward to provide more room, so facing each other does not equate to knees being interlocked. In fact, with 7 feet 8 inches between the seats, they're not even close. Sitting forward, the seat bases flip up to form backrests, and the arms are drawn to the top of the bolsters 20 inches above the seat cushions. And there's also a recessed grab rail. The teak table actuates up and down, and a pad on top will convert the whole area into a sun pad. Just behind is a large double-wide lounge. Armrests are to the sides, and in the center, an armrest flips down that includes a pair of beverage holders, a self-draining cell phone cubby, and a connectivity port is just behind. The storage is greatly improved in the bow. In the deck alone, we can fit several 5-gallon buckets in this 3 feet 2 inch by 3 foot by 20 inch compartment. If the electrically actuated table isn't chosen, then this can be a macerated fish box. The V-seat storage opens with a single remote latch for one-handed access, and there's been great improvements to the storage under the lounge seating. With previous models, this was the rod storage area, so to get anything, the rods had to come out first. Now the rods are moved down below in a climate-controlled environment, by the way. So now this is wide-open storage space that can hold huge amounts of gear and tanks. Taken all together, this is a luxurious gathering area feature-packed with some of the most sought-after amenities customer feedback could compile. As we head back, to both sides, the rail tops out at 36 inches with 20-inch wide deck space. There's storage, a forward-facing speaker, cargo net storage, and flip-down jump seats. The padded bolsters wrap around the entire boat. To the port side of the helm seat, there's a refrigerated drawer. Back in the cockpit, the aft-facing seat enhances the utility of the area. It has storage underneath, converts quite easily to a buffet table, and notice the teak surface. A flip-out seat at the transom adds even more seating and closes when more room is needed. We can also add a set of cockpit tables for even more versatility, and yet another flip-down seat is to the starboard bulkhead. The tables store close by under the deck hatch, and notice how cleverly the brackets allow the table to pivot away before sliding out. Overhead, a retractable awning electrically actuates to provide shade to the entire cockpit area. With the starboard console, Boston Whaler created the ability to move the cabin entry to this area just to the port of the helm. Now, we can have the full weather enclosure option while still being able to access the cabin from that protected environment. This is a huge improvement over the side or front of the console entry. Inside, we measured 6 feet 5 inches to the overhead skylight. To starboard, there's a microwave behind a retractable door. Below, there's a vessel sink recessed into a Corian counter, and an opening port light is just beyond. Notice that the sink is elevated just above the counter, so we also have a quick drop spot for cell phones and wallets, complete with a raised edge. Trash goes below. Ahead is a seating area that converts to a double berth. Storage solutions played a big part in the cabin. Of course, there's the rod storage we discussed that moves the rods out of the bow compartment, and I like the blue courtesy lighting just above. Cabinets are above and shelving is above that, and take a look at this. If we flip these seat backs down, they all have rubberized surfaces, so when we bring aboard our plastic storage totes, this gives us a place to put them without having them slide off. Additional bins or other items can go just ahead of the cushions, and they're also prevented from sliding by the cushions themselves. This is a real-world solution, and a clever one. However, the biggest improvement to this below-deck area is the fully enclosed head. The door is held open with a magnetic catch. The head includes a flip-down teak seat, pull-out shower wand, opening port light, mirror, and my favorite feature, the flip-down foul weather gear hooks. Great place to dry out your jackets. The heat and AC vents speeds that process up. Clearly, this is a boat with a lot to offer, and she's pretty well set up with everything customer research has shown that boaters in this class are looking for. Her new hull design performed flawlessly, and the automatic controlling from the Mercury systems are a perfect complement. As for comfort, it's everywhere we stepped, and then some. And that's my full sea trial and features walkthrough of the all-new 380 Outrage from Boston Whaler. For BoatTest.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.